I actually think that, you know, as has been typical of much of the Trump presidency, he had sort of the right instinct, which he has managed to pursue in the worst possible way, and therefore produced a result that's much worse than we might have gotten otherwise. But the failure in Syria goes back a long way. It doesn't begin with Donald Trump. It doesn't begin last week. It began with the fact that the United States has never, since the Syrian uprising began, known what it was actually trying to accomplish there.
Ben Franklin, who said, democracy is like two wolves and a lamb voting on what to have for lunch. You don't have to be a rocket scientist to know how that vote is going to go. But he said, liberty is making sure that that lamb is well armed to protest that vote. And so with open season, I endeavored to help the young lambs in communities of color be able to protest the vote, to give them the information and arm them with intellect and diplomacy to be able to protest the school to prison pipeline, be able to protest the racist Jim Crow laws like Stand Your Ground, to be able to protest voter suppression.
It's common to say in the area of gun violence that we need more research, and the assumption there, implicit in that statement, is that we don't really know what works to reduce gun violence. That's not true in relation to urban gun violence. Urban gun violence is the most studied, most rigorously studied form of gun violence, and we've learned a tremendous amount about it. My book is based on over 1,400 individual, rigorous, quasi-experimental, and experimental impact evaluations.
We all know environmental toxicity is omnipresent. We're all affected by it. Recent studies show that 95% of us harbor pesticides in our residue in our body, pesticides that were banned 40 years ago, still infest our baby food and our bodies. But for African Americans, Hispanic Americans, and Native Americans, the problem is compounded, because many of them are forced to live in close proximity to very potent sources of environmental toxicity. In recent years, we've all been reading about lead exposure, right? We've all been reading about the racial disparity in lead exposure. But lead exposure is only one very small part of the problem, as horrible as it is.